So today I'm going to talk about Fiducial marker. So Fiducial markers are basically a reference point on the PCB. As you can see that on this PCB board, there are two Fiducial points which I put here. They look like in 2D. You can see here, this is the first one and this is the second one. So Fiducial markers are basically, it's a round shoulder mask opening with round bare copper in the center. And bare copper has a really smaller diameter than the shoulder mask. Through Fiducial marker, it is possible for shoulder press printer machines and optical inspection system to precisely measure the circuit structure. It's not like that without Fiducial marker, the machine, this shoulder paste printer, this automatic machine cannot manufacture the board or cannot print out the board. But the problem is that, for example, then this machine has to take some other points in on your PCB as a reference point, which means that it need more time to produce the PCB, which means that your process will become more time consuming and it will cost more. So that's why, to avoid that, it's always better to put at least two Fiducial marker on the PCB where you have your SMD component. So for example, in this PCB, as I'm having only on the top side, I just place few components to show that. So that's why you have to place your Fiducial marker always, for this PCB on the top side. And then, for example, if you have also component on the back side, in my case, they are not there. But if in your case, to have a component on the back side, then it would always be better to put two Fiducial marker on the back side of the PCB. There are many ways actually to make the symbol and footprint of Fiducial marker, and this is the way I'm using since so many years. So I will show you how to make in your library as a component Fiducial marker. So as I said that add in your project as make a new project like integrated library, and then add in that schematic library and PCB library, and then go to the schematic library. So what you have to do, you have to go
to place and choose ellipse
and then place it here. So finish it, go here, take the smallest, change the color to black. I like the black. Say the radius is 0.5. X and epsilon, is that too small? Yeah, I think so. So, okay. Then I will show you how it looks like, and then fill the color here, black. Okay, then again,
you have to go to place and choose ellipse.
Here in the center, again, the X radius is, I will take 1.27 millimeter, X and epsilon, then change it to small, the borders, and I like the black color, so black, and then transparent, then fill the color here. I would say I like the yellow one, maybe a bit lighter yellow. Yeah, so that's how it is. And now you can go to edit, then move, and then bring to the front. Choose this, bring to the front. So you have to choose that, and then after that, so now you have to click on the inner ellipse, and then it will bring you to the front. And then you can add here the rest of the parameter like comment value and all those things if you want. Fiducial marker and designator ideas FM. Yeah, so that's how it is. So now we are finished with the symbol So let me show you how to make a footprint for Fiducial marker. What you have to do, you have to go to place and then choose pad. Once you choose the pad, I'm in a single mode. So let me first place this pad here. This is the origin. And now I'm on the top layer. So now what you have to do, you have to click on this pad. And first thing you have to do is that you have to bring it to the top layer. If you don't bring it to the top layer, where is that? Properties. Yeah. Here, if you don't bring it to the top layer, then in pad stack, it will ask you regarding the hole size and all these things, which will be confusing for you. I mean, later on you will see that we don't need all this hole size and rest of the things. So the best way is to bring it on the top side, because we are not going to make a hole here. So let me bring it to the top side, top layer. So once you are on a top layer, then go to the pad stack. Pad, we need 1 millimeter is enough for me. That is the minimum required, and if it's more than that, it's always good. Best mask expansion, normally it's 0 here. In our case, for example, here, as we don't have to place any component or to shoulder on this pad or on this place, so we don't need any kind of paste mask. It's just a copper on PCB. So go to manual and say, for example, you can see paste mask like this. So now what you can do, you can go to here in the properties of paste mask expansion, go to manual and say we don't need, which means that as our say radius is 1 millimeter for the outer surface, so we have to say here -1 millimeter, set here -1 millimeter, which means that there won't be any kind of paste mask expansion. So next thing is that shoulder mask expansion. We do need that, but not 0.1 millimeter. By default, what it's written here, we need this is also big, which is around twice the radius of the top layer pad. So here our pad is 1 millimeter. Radius is 0.5 millimeter. So we need here, say 1 millimeter. So that's how it looks like. Yeah. So now what you can do, now we are done with this, I think. Yeah. And then, so that's how it looks like in 3D mode. Let me put it here. 3D body, extruded 3D body. Go to extruded 3D body, choose the center and place it here. I removed it. So place, go to place, extruded 3D body, and then it's on mechanical layer 12. So that's why I'm on a mechanical layer 12. Click here, or you can go to press on tab, and then it will bring you to the properties of this 3D model type. Choose here cylinder. Once you choose the cylinder, then choose the height. 0.1 millimeter is enough. Radius is 0.5. It should be same as the pad on the top layer, and then standard of height I will add here. So -0.02 is okay. And now, as soon as you finish all these things, the parameter, I mean, then it will ask you where you have to paste it, and then you have to choose this center. Once you paste this, then it looks like this. Okay, so like this. Yeah, then I think the strand of height should be 0.2, not 0.02. There is some strand of height between, yeah, the Fiducial marker and the 3D body. So now we are almost done. What we have to do here more is that we have to make sure that that there should be some distance of the routing vias and the other component pads which are placed nearby this Fiducial marker. So what I can do, I can go to place, then keep out, and then choose the full circle, click on the center and expand the full circle, and then go to the properties of this keep out, make the width 2.1 millimeter, which is, sorry, 0.01 millimeter, then radius is 1.5 millimeter, and yeah, so here you can say okay. So here automatically the keep out restriction is applied for vias, track, copper, SMD pad and through hole pad, which means that as soon as you will put in your design rule keep out restrictions, so it will keep the pad, vias and copper copper material or track away from this shoulder mask expansion. So in my case, for example, I normally put 0.5 millimeter, which means that all this, it will make sure that there should be 0.5 millimeter distance from the pad or the vias or the track of the layout from this shoulder mask expansion. Let me bring this component, for example, here, and if it's this the distance of the pad is not from the outer circle of this is 0.5 millimeter, in DRC check, design rule check, it will give you failure. So you have to make sure that there is sufficient distance between these two parts. Yeah, so that's how you can create Fiducial marker. So now we have the symbol for Fiducial marker and now footprint for Fiducial marker. So the next thing is that what you can do is you can go to add footprint, browse, you have here this Fiducial marker, so choose this. If you don't find it, then go to your library here. From here you can go to your library and then choose that Fiducial marker and say okay, and now you can see that it's available here, and you can here go to project, compile integrated library, and in message, if it's successful, then it will show you here. So here, as you can see that it's successful, there is no error. Yeah, thank you very much. If you like my videos, please like it, share it, and subscribe it. And if you have any kind of questions, please write it in comments. Thank you.